Hello, spider peeps. Oh, look, you can barely see that board on there. So in the last video, I started to populate a board like this to use this NFC reader on it and use a Wemos device to have an interface to use OpenSpool. And I've been trying to build it without the instructions because at the time when I originally filmed this, there were no instructions for it on the website. So today we're going to do the second half of that video. Because we were waiting for one of these, an upgraded version of these, to arrive. And guess what? Okay, so here's my S3 Mini arrived 3 days earlier from AliExpress than I was expecting it. This should now align with that perfectly. And look, it's even SpiderMaf purple as well. Excellent. All right, now it came with these headers, so it didn't come with double row headers, unfortunately. So it's come with single row that I can use twice, but I'm feeling more and more uncomfortable about soldering those directly onto the board. So I think what I'm going to do is put the pins on this board, and then I'm going to put some sockets on this board just in case I've done this wrong somehow, so that I can mess about with the sockets and put the sockets on a different way if there's a problem. So I think what I'll need to do is put the sockets on the reverse of the board like that, and then put the pins on that there. So time for a montage. Not a montage, that would be loads of different shots. Time for a time lapse. That'll do. It's not even a time lapse, is it? Let's just fast forward. Okay, so that's almost it, I think. So this should go on there because I tried really hard to get these two close together. It should fit on without a problem. Then this should go on the back. I think maybe there's one more thing. I wouldn't mind putting that little LED on there. So I think I'm just going to wire up an RGB LED and pop that on there as well. All right, so I'm going to plug it in and see what happens. I programmed the board earlier. Hopefully the LED will do something. Obviously we know logic's working if this comes up with a reasonable colour. So let's see. That looks well promising. Pulsing blue. Whoa. So I wonder what might happen if I just get one of these and put it close to it, I wonder if anything will change. I don't know whether I have to tell the software to do something. Well, no, it's not doing anything at the moment, so. Right, let's see what it says on the screen. All right, so this wire is just going to the power. It is actually going to another computer, but that doesn't matter. And I've connected this to my local network. If we go to the computer, here's the page that I can see. Yep, so there's various bits going on there. And you see, obviously, this is set up to just do the filaments and things like that, which is why it's showing the filaments anyway. So this isn't just RFID reader. I keep on saying NFC. I think, didn't that stand for near field communication? That's why I'm saying NFC all the time. But now, of course, NFC is a non-fungible cabbages. I don't know. Anyway, yeah, so sorry in the earlier video and this video that I've been saying NFCs, but RFID, yeah, so it'll read some other RFID tags as well. I mean, the best thing to do is to just try now one of these tags from the filament. So let's put it underneath. Does it do anything? Right, haha. So that's cool. So it's gone red saying it can't read it, but on the screen its authentication is failed. I think that's because these are encrypted, so it has to send a message to my bamboo printer, which is what all the fuss is about, to decrypt that. So I'm not going to go into that on this video. This is just to see where they could build this board. She's working. All right, let's try the one the other side. I mean, it's going to be the same thing. Yeah. All right, so that's not found. This is one of the tags that came with it. So what does that read? Okay, it's still saying authentication failed. Maybe there's other things that we could do with that, but yeah. Let's just try the blank card that they sent me. Yeah, so it's done something. Again, it's not read properly. But I went to a fun factory the other day. This is one of those things that you buy and you get all the tickets from. Well, you buy your 2p's on it for coin falls and stuff like that, because none of the machines seem to take money anymore. This is one of those that I found in one of those arcades, and I wonder whether it'll read that. Let's just see whether this is a My Fair Classic as well. It'd be really funny if you could recharge these, although highly illegal. But that's still a My Fair Classic. Found new tag, waiting to read next tag. So that was 2A10A4AE. And what's this one? 07712333. Yeah, different tag name, different message as well. Yeah, so that's this OpenSpool working then. I'm sure there'll be other people who've done videos about that or will do, but this was how to order and assemble one of these OpenSpool PCBs, and it works quite well. So I can't wait. Spuder puts the STLs on so I can make a nice little case for this. Then of course it might be useful just as an NFC reader. No, an RFID reader anyway, to do other things with, not necessarily using the software to reprogram the filament spools. All right, I hope you found this interesting. If you enjoy my videos, please subscribe. Give me a thumbs up for this if you enjoyed it, and otherwise, bye.